Good morning, students. I heartily welcome you all of you to 9th standard. Today, let's start a new lesson in mathematics, that is number system. So, you are already familiar with numbers. So, in previous classes like 8th and 7th standard, you already learned various types of numbers. And also, in 8th standard, playing with numbers. There also you have learned this. So, let's recall what are the numbers you have learned in previous classes. So, first, basically, natural numbers. So natural numbers are denoted by n, and the series of natural number is given by 1, 2, 3, 4 up to n. So for what reason we are going to use natural numbers? So what is the importance of natural numbers in mathematics? So if there are n number of students, if there are 20 number of students in your class, and your teacher says you to count the number of students in your class, then you start with 1, like 1, 2, 3, 4. Means these are the counting numbers. Natural numbers are counting numbers. We start counting from 1, like that. Up to how many numbers we can count? Yes, we can count up to infinitely many numbers. Means, so which is the last number in which is the last natural number? We cannot say, because we can write infinitely many number of numbers in a natural numbers. So what is the series of natural number represents? So series of natural number n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to infinity. Then whole numbers. So whole numbers, they are the natural numbers. Along with that, we have one more number, that is 0. So natural numbers along with 0 are whole numbers. Natural numbers along with 0 is what? Whole numbers denoted by z, w. Whole numbers are denoted by w, and the series of whole number is given by w is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. Next, integers. So integers are denoted by letter z. So z is equal to infinity minus 3, comma minus 2, minus 1, comma minus 0, comma plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, like that. Means the integer contains positive integers, negative integers, and also a zero. Say, if I write plus z, then plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, plus 4 are just 3, 4, like that. So plus 1 can be written just 1 is nothing but plus 1. If I written 3, means it is understood that it is plus 3. So integers have positive integers, that is plus 1, plus 2, plus 3, 4, 5, 6. These represents what? The positive integers, minus 1, comma minus 2, comma minus 3. So these up to infinity represents negative integers, and 0, 0 is neither positive nor negative. So this is a series of integer, that is z is equal to infinity up to minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, comma 0, comma plus 1, 2, comma 3 up to infinity. Next, these we have already learnt in previous classes. Let's come to rational numbers. So what do you mean by rational numbers? So rational numbers means any number r is said to be a rational number. If a number r is said to be rational number, if that particular number r can be able to express, can be written in the form of p by q, in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers, where p and q are integers, means p and q may be, so p and q are integers, they may be positive integers or negative integers. And also we have another condition, that the denominator q should not be equal to 0. Even 0 is also integer, the denominator q should not be equal to 0. So these are the rational numbers. So what do you mean by rational number? Numbers, any number r can be written in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers, but q is not equal to 0. This is the definition of rational number. So you can take examples like 1 by 2, 3 by 5, 7 by 9. You can write infinitely many number of rational numbers. You can give any number of examples for this. Then what will be irrational numbers? Just reverse of rational number. If you reverse the definition of rational number, you will get the definition of irrational numbers. So what do you mean by rational numbers? A number, if it is possible to express in the form of p by q, it is rational. If a number is not able to express in the form of p by q, if any number is not able to express in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0, then we can say that is a irrational number. So about irrational numbers we are going to learn in the same lesson and further topics in detail. Okay, so now in your textbook they are given some statements and they ask you to say whether the given statements are true or false, and if it is true, why it is true, if it is false, why it is false. So first one, every whole number is a natural number. So just you can see the series of integers, natural number and also whole number. They are saying that every whole number, each and every whole number is a natural number. Is it true or false? What do you say? If every whole number is a natural number, is it true or false? Yes, it is false, because 0 is a whole number. 0 is a whole number, but it is not a natural number. So except 0, all the numbers are natural numbers. But they are saying every means each and every whole number is a natural number. So it is a wrong statement. So we can write it is false. So the answers for this are given in your textbook. You have to copy the example number 1 as it is. Means you write the statement and given, they have in the textbook they have given the answers for that. Just copy from your textbook. So every whole number is a natural number. False, because 0 is a natural number, but it is not a whole number. Like that they have given your textbook. Just copy it from your textbook. Next, see the second statement. Every integer is a rational number. Every integer is a rational number. So rational number means it should be in the form of p by q. Where p and q should be integers and the denominator q should not be equal to 0. Now they are saying that every integer means minus 3, minus 1, or plus 1, 0, whatever may be the number you can take, it should be able to express in the form of p by q. Okay, so now is it possible to express 0 in the form of p by q? Yes. So 0 by 1 can be written as 0 by 1. So this statement is true. This statement is true. Because you take any number, say m, that is integer, which may be a negative number, positive number or 0, it can easily write in the form of m by 1. So where m is an integer, 1 is also an integer, which is not equal to 0. So this is the true statement. Next, third one. Every rational number is an integer. Every rational number is an integer. So some rational numbers are integer. So they are saying that every rational number is an integer. See, is 1 is a rational number? Yes, because can write this in the form of 1 by 1. So where 1 and 1 are integers and denominator is not equal to 0, therefore 1 is a rational number, 1 is also an integer. But there are some rational numbers, they represent only rational number but not integers. See, so if I write here 3 by 2, so 3 by 2 is a rational number, but is it an integer? No. So 3 by 2 is a rational number, but it is not integer. Means every rational number is an integer. This is a wrong statement. It is false, because some rational numbers may be integers but not all. Every means each and every number should satisfy this statement. So 3 by 2 is a rational number in the form of p by q, but it is not counts in the integer sequence. Okay. So this is also a false statement. Yes, only thing you have to do it, just understand this and you copy example number 1 from your textbook as this, with the statement they have explained the answer as it is. Okay. Now, see the second example. Find 5 rational numbers between 1 and 2. Find 5 rational numbers between 1 and 2. So, 1 is a rational number, 2 is also a rational number because 1 can be written as 1 by 1, 2 can be written as 2 by 1. It is an integer, it is a whole number, it is a natural number, it is a rational number. So, these two are rational numbers are integers. So, what we have to write is, we have to write any five rational numbers between the two numbers. So, to write the rational numbers between two given rational numbers, first we have to see how many numbers we have to find that we have to take into account. So, 5 numbers we have to find, let it n is equal to 5. Let n is equal to 5. Then add 1 to the n plus 1, that is 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. So 5 numbers we have to find, just add 1 to it, we will get 6. So by 6 we have to multiply and divide. We have to multiply and divide to the both the given numbers. Therefore, we can easily write any number of rational numbers between any two numbers. So the first number is 1. Just multiply and divide by 6. So we have second number is 2. Multiply and divide by 6. So 1 into 6 is 6. By 6 is the first number. 2 6 is 12 by 6. Don't simplify it. So 6 by 6 and 12 by 6. Now we have to find. We have to write 5 rational numbers between these two. It is very easy to write between these two. 6 by 6. The next number is 7 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6, 10 by 6, 11 by 6. These are the 5 rational numbers. Therefore, 6 by 6, next number is 7 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6, 10 by 6, 11 by 6. So don't write the next number 12 by 6. So 7 by 6, 8 by 6, 9 by 6, 10 by 6 and 11 by 6 are the 5 rational numbers between 1 and 2. So what if they ask us to find 6 rational numbers between 2 rational numbers? So then, if you want to find 6 rational numbers, then just add 1 to it. 6 plus 1 becomes 7. You have to multiply 7 by 7 to both the two numbers and write the numbers in between them. That is the answer. Okay. So like this, you can write n number of, infinitely many number of rational numbers between any two numbers. Yes. Now let's solve some of the examples from exercise 1.1. So we will not give you separate notes after reopening the school. So you have to copy the notes, you have to make the notes by watching the videos. So immediately after completion of video, so what are the things what we are going to write on the board, you copy those examples as it is, and the homeworks what we will give, that also you have to do in the notes only. So if you have any doubts the homework, then first do it in rough notes. If you are sure that it is correct answer, then you can directly write in the notes only. Okay. So now the first question is whether is 0 a rational number. Is it possible to express 0 in the form of p by q, where p is not equal to 0, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0. So that we have to see. So yes, 0 is a rational number. 0 is a rational number because 0 can be written, can be expressed in the form of 0 by q, that is again equal to 0 only. So 0 is a rational number. 0 is a rational number. Why? Because 0 can be expressed, can be written in the form of 0 by q. You can take example that 0 by 2. If you divide 0 into 2 parts, again you will get the 0 only. 0 means nothing. We are dividing nothing. Okay. So 0 by 2 is also 0. Where 0 is an integer, 2 is also integer, and 2 is not equal to 0, therefore it is a rational number. 0 by 5 is equal to 0. Like this, you can write any number of examples. Yes, now you can say that 0 is a rational number. Next, the second example. So what example what was solved in the previous part, that is on the basis of same one. The third one, five rational numbers between two rational numbers 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. The method what we have followed to solve the previous example, same thing we have to do. See, we have to find 5 rational numbers, therefore add 1 to it, we get 6. So 5 plus 1 is 6. Means we have to divide and multiply by 6 to both 3 by 5 and also to 4 by 5. So write 3 by 5, multiply and divide by 6. So 3 6 is 18, 5 6 is 30. Means we have to multiply numerator, denominator to denominator. So 18 by 30. Then the second number 4 by 5. Second number is 4 by 5. So 4 by 5. Again, multiply by 6 and divide by 6. So 6 4s are 24, 5 6 are 30. Now we have got two numbers, 18 by 30, 20 by 24 by 30. Now it is very easy to write numbers between these two. So 18 by 30, what is the next number? Yes, 19 by 30, 20 by 30, 21 by 30, 22 by 30, 23 by 30, up to that we have to write. Until you get 5 numbers, you have to write. Therefore, the required 5 rational numbers are, the first number is 18 by 30, the next number of this is 19 by 30, next 20 by 30, 21 by 30, so what is the next number? Yes, it is 22 by 30, the last number is 23 by 30. So 18 by 30, 19 by 30, 20 by 30, 21 by 30, 22 by 30, 23 by 30, 24 by 30. So like this, you have to write required number of rational numbers between any two numbers. So we can conclude that we can write infinitely many, n number of numbers, rational numbers between any two rational numbers. Now see the next question, fourth one. So they have given some statements and asked us to rectify or say whether it is true or false with the reason. So first one is, every natural number is a whole number. Every natural number is a whole number. So just we discussed that the series of natural number, which includes n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4 up to infinity. The same way, series of whole numbers, w is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to infinity. So what they are saying is, every natural number is a whole number. Is it true or false? Yes, it is true. So you can take any natural number and compare that whether it is a whole number or not. So you take 15. 15 is a natural number. Whether it is a whole number? Yes. 1, natural number, whole number. Like that, you can take any number from the series of natural number, you will find that it is also a whole number. Okay. So it is true because set of all natural numbers belongs to set of all whole numbers. Means each and every number that includes, that comes under natural number, it is also comes in a whole number series. Okay. Now second one is, every integer is a whole number. Every integer is a whole number. So we know that integer includes both positive integers, negative integers and also 0. Every integer is a whole number. So whole number means it starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 up to infinity. But in a series of whole number, we don't find any negative numbers. Remember that in a series of whole number, we will not get any negative numbers. But integer means it also contains negative numbers. So it is false statement because minus 3 is a integer, it's a negative integer, but it's not a whole number. So minus 3 will not comes in a series of whole number. It is false because integer, the series of integer also includes negative numbers, but whole numbers does not include any negative numbers, therefore it's a false statement. Next, third one is every rational number is a whole number. Every rational number is a whole number. Rational number means it should be in the form of p by q, where p and q are integers and q should not be equal to 0, right? So it is also false because 1 by 2, or you can write 3 by 2, 5 by 7, like that, you can write any rational number of your choice and that just compare that whether it is a whole number or not. So 7 by 3 or 1 by 2 is a rational number, but it's not a whole number. Therefore, it's a false. To say every means each and every number should satisfy this. Yes, there are some numbers which are rational numbers and also whole numbers. Say if I write 3. So 3 can be written as 3 by 1. So 3 by 1 is a rational number. So 3 by 1 is equal to 3. So 3 is a whole number. For this, it is satisfied. But when say every means each and every number should satisfy. Therefore, it is false. False because 1 by 2 is a rational number, but it's not a whole number. Okay, students, let's continue in the next class. Thank you.